Hi, I'm Maddie Stack, and we're here on Underground Mix with Henri, Joyal, and Austin O'Meara. They just did a DJ set for us. So what is dubstep exactly?
I wouldn't consider myself dubstep. Dubstep is kind of more like a drum and like a heavy bass.
Drum and bass,
like really distorted, kind of deep bass sounding, and it's mainly focused around...
It's all around mainly bass and bass, like a synth. And whatnot.
Yeah, and what I do is like producing. I'll take like a keyboard, like a synthesizer, run it into my computer and record parts, and you know, record a drum part off the synthesizer, or you know, use already preset drum loops in there, and once I have everything, you know, everything I've recorded, I put it all together, and then I play it in a song. And I consider mine more of kind of like electronic hip hop. Kind of geared towards like more instrumental hip hop music.
What about you? What would you classify your music more as?
My music is more of considering the same thing as him, but I like more mixing.
Mm-hmm.
More that if I'm performing a show, that I'll mix more dubstep and dance, electronica, whatnot, of what people want to hear, and also mix it in with your own type of stuff. Like you could have a dubstep song going on, but still have faders in the background and background noise
effects
and effects
on.
And
right.
You know, people talking or whatnot.
There's so much you can do with it.
There's a lot of things you can do, but mainly dubstep is mostly like, it's all mainstream now because
right.
It's all just, you know, a beat and pretty much just noise.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
So how did you get into making your own music, and like how did you learn how to do this? Because I know it's a very like new type of thing.
Yeah, it is pretty new. Like most of what the music's coming to now of like when people are performing, like DJs now are completely different of what DJ used to be like 4 years ago, not even. I mean, totally, you could be like, there's completely different DJs, like a DJ that does scratching, you know,
yeah,
or a DJ like Pretty Lights.
People that used to walk around use a beat pads, backpack full of records and used to match up records.
Yeah, and whatnot.
Beats. I got into it because I played all sorts of different instruments, like bass, guitar, a little bit of keyboard and everything. And I always wanted to just kind of put all the instruments I play together and make my own music. And I listened to like a lot of hip-hop instrumentals and whatnot, and I thought it sounded cool. And so I finally got enrolled in a music class in the city, where I learned how to do music production and whatnot. And I just started getting really into it. And as electronic music started progressing, like I knew that it would sound cool to like kind of throw that in and mix it in with you know, simple instruments, make it sound a lot cooler than it is.
So I don't really consider us dubstep, maybe more of like sampling
electronic
items, like electronic music pretty much, sampling items, making like a hip hop beat to it, and maybe putting like a little like soul music in there, you know, experimental.
Anything you want, you know.
How did you get into it, Henri?
I play the drums and I can play the keyboards, and I'm really I like music a lot, so I like to play a lot of different instruments. And mainly it came up from mostly listening to most of the music that I listen to. All the people that perform that music are using the same exact things that we are right now. They use Ableton, the software. Like anyone that I listen to pretty much uses it. So just kind of got the idea, hey, why don't I do this? This is easy. Why can't I just start making beats? We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Do you guys like practice for this? Like, if you like, when you do, do you do shows regularly?
No, we really do not. I mean, we need to start.
Well, yeah, I mean, I didn't practice at all. I mean, I need to get a new. I'm kind of antsy to perform because my computer's a piece of junk and it's freezing up a lot. So, I mean, Christmas is coming soon, so I'm gonna do a laptop. But I mean,
pretty much like if you're gonna have like a show, you should. You know, you have, like, if you're going to do live, you should have a lot of live sets up of, like, a ton of, like, you know, like, you could have already have songs already playing just with effects, you know, your own effects to the songs, and then you can all of a sudden just go to your song you make and stuff and mix things up. So if you have, like, a lot of, like, party mixes or whatnot, stuff loaded.
Yeah, you can do a lot.
A lot of stuff on there, then, yeah, you can do
it's
stuff.
It's so hard to, like, narrow it down, like, get to the point. It's there's so much you can do.
All right.
But
well,
it's a blast.
Thanks for coming on the show with us. That was Underground Mix. This is Austin O'Mara and Henri Joyal. All right. Thanks
and
for watching.
And you guys can look me up on SoundCloud under Beat Laboratory, and that's BEATLA B O R A T O R Y.
Period.
Period.